f of negative 1 and f of 5. So no IUT.
I can't spell. I don't know what's happening.
Well, I don't even try.
I should spell in between with a D.
I know.
Thank you.
Cool.
You know, I don't think I could deal without smart aleckiness.
I think you could.
I don't think I could.
I think you could. I live with a smart aleck, so.
Me too.
Okay.
Oh.
Same.
The teenage years are humps.
Well, mine is 20, so.
They never go away.
Because his
my husband's 44 and he's still
he
one.
Can't live with them.
Oh.
So.
What two conditions must be true? We're on the back. Must be true to verify the applicability. Ooh, nice word.
Applicability.
Applicability of the IBT.
There has to be a.
Okay, yeah. There has to be a what?
A C. Let's see.
A C between what?
F of A and F of B.
Yes. So F of C
must be defined.
Must be between F of A and F of B. What else has to be true?
It has.
What was wrong with the first one? Yeah, continuous. F of X. Must be continuous on A to B.
Are we gonna have to do like proofs on every math thing we do now? Like,
proofs? We haven't
like,
done
this
a proof.
It's a theorem. So like we have to like.
Oh, like give a list thingy?
Yeah.
These kind of for some thingies.
Yes. I love these lists.
Okay.
What?
So, for each of the following functions, we're going to determine if the IBT is applicable
no.
or not. Yes, we are.
No,
and we're going to state why or why not. Then, if it is applicable, find the value of C guaranteed to exist by the theorem.
Cool.
So, number one, we got to determine if f of x is continuous from negative 1 to 3.
So we'll be
plugging
negative 1 and then 3.
Woo! So, to figure out if it's continuous, we look at the equation. Where is that equation not continuous?
Nowhere.
3 and negative 2?
Not 3.
Negative 2 though? Negative
yeah,
two.
What happens at negative 2?
There's a hole, probably?
Not a hole. A hole is when they cancel.
Oh, it's over zero?
It's over zero, so which does that cause?
Asymptote.
Oh. It's a vertical asymptote. So at x equals negative 2, there's a vertical asymptote. That's where it is undefined or not continuous. So
it's not between negative 1 and 3.
There you go. Negative 2 is not in between negative 1 and 3. So I don't have to worry about it.
Sadly.
Happily.
Sadly. No, this is what will be done.
True. F of X is continuous on negative 1 to 3. I'm gonna say so. Okay. Number two, I have to show that f of c is in between f of a and f of b.
Two-thirds.
Which means f of negative 1, because I'm using these two points, x and the y.
Right.
Or I mean the x and the x.
Equals negative 4 over 1.
There we go, actually.
Thank you.
So that's negative 4. And f of 3?
Would be 0
over
5. Yeah.
Okay, so 0, right?
Yes.
So is 2/3 between negative 4 and 0?
No.
No. F of C equals 2/3 is not between F of -1 and F of 3. Therefore, the IVT
yes.
is not applicable.
Applicable.
It's not time yet.
We have 2 minutes.
It's time for calculus.
We have 2 minutes left, and I
just
don't want to be caught no more.
I wonder what Harvey's. Hi, Harvey.
We're having fun over here.
We miss you.
Save us.
Oh my gosh, I'm gonna have to split this up. It's like 18 minutes.
Gotcha.
I can do it.
Yep. I figured out how to do it.
Did you figure out how to do it on iMovie?
No, I do it on PhotoBooth. Because that's what I record on.
Awesome.
Oh, you don't drag it in the iMovie?
Lord, no, because that would take too long.
No.
That takes like 5 seconds.
Yeah, but it takes 5 seconds more than not doing it.
Really?
Yeah,
really.
You can just split it in preview.
Sure? Exactly, I just split it. Okay, number two.
Yes.
F of x, same equation.
No.
This time we're going from -4 to 1. Again, for f of c equals 2/3.
Is it going to be the same? -2 is in there, so we're done. Cool.
Okay, you're right. Ashley, why are we done?
Because -2 is a vertical asymptote, and it's between -4 and 1.
Yes, so since f of x is discontinuous, Saved by the Bell, we'll finish this up.
I've never seen that TV show.
You're not missing a whole lot.